A stroke is a very common disease. The brain is not getting enough blood flow because either a blood vessel becomes hardened and narrowed, or it's blocked by a blood clot, or it ruptures because the blood vessel wall becomes weak, leading to bleeding within the brain or around the brain.
Time is critical in these situations because the longer a blood vessel stays blocked, the more brain cells will die.
There's few things more devastating than a patient having a stroke. It affects their identity, their ability to be productive.
Decades ago, when you see somebody with a stroke, you would provide your empathy and then you'd have to move on because there wasn't much to offer. Doing stroke research and investing in stroke treatments was thought to be a graveyard. That's changing. This is reinvigorating stroke research, very broadly speaking.
There's an urgency to diagnose through clinical evaluations and neuroimaging and then offer the best treatments that we can for these patients.
Getting those therapies earlier results in better outcomes. Earlier is important. Time matters. When you think about stroke, one of the fundamental things that you need to do is figure out what kind of a stroke a patient's having. The only way you can figure that out is by taking a look with a brain image. An MRI is this incredibly safe technology that's very powerful, but because of high magnetic field and power requirements, it's usually in a basement. And as a result, even though it's very important, very difficult for patients to access. Here at Yale, for the first time in the world, both developed and deployed a portable MRI machine. We've taken an MRI from that secure bunker, and we've brought it to the bedside. And this has been incredibly exciting, as you can imagine. The pictures are getting better and better, and we're constantly coming up with new ideas for what we can do with a very exciting technology.
Under normal circumstances, the brain has the unique ability to regulate its own blood flow. Brain tissue is very vulnerable during the first hours after stroke. How do we manage blood pressure in the very acute phase after someone has had a stroke? The ideal blood pressure after someone has had a stroke depends on many factors. So using a one-size-fits-all approach for blood pressure management after stroke is likely inadequate. We're currently using neuromonitoring technology that helps us identify the blood pressure that's ideal for this individual person so that the brain has the best chances to heal from the stroke.
When there's injury anywhere in the body sets up an inflammatory reaction. The same thing happens in the brain. And so we're trying to understand how can we harness the immune system's knowledge about how to repair tissues after they've been injured. Once you've dealt with the initial blood vessel problem, either stopped the bleeding or reopened the blocked blood vessel, we now have a lot of injury that's still ongoing over days. By understanding what the signals are that tell the immune system to stop making pro-inflammatory factors and start making growth factors and start healing the brain, we can find new therapies, new treatments for patients with stroke that minimize that early injury and really enhance their ability to recover.
Those patients that come back from a severe stroke to go on and live a normal, meaningful life, that's really inspiring, even though we're up against a terrible disease. But we're making progress. We're constantly getting better and improving the therapies, and that's because of clinical research.
What motivates me is that the interventions and treatments that we were evaluating and studying 10 years ago are now part of a standard of care, a clinical practice, which is enabling us to reduce death and disability to our patients.
What motivates me in the research realm is thinking that at some point, maybe one of the discoveries that we make in lab can actually translate into a new therapy that would allow a patient to walk again or speak again or return to their normal lives.
There's always something nice about trying to attack something that people said can't be done. We're going to sprint towards those areas because they're important and because we like to do the unique thing.
We want to be able to lead research efforts that change the lives of patients around the world.